Technically, they don't really have a reliable source of engage, so that Sicilian is going to have a very fun time. The thing is, will they be able to survive the early game? Because Onyx ID, they did the exact same thing. They brought out the Sicilian on Dreon, and that was the game that was most dominant towards Blacklist International. But let's see if they can execute it. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for game two? Welcome to the Land of Dawn. Blacklist once again goes on to look for a match point while EVO's SG tries to equalize on the board.
Let's see how they're going to play this out. Now, I know you've caught something up here, Wolf. What would you sniff out here? What's going on?
Jungle Nathan, if you have Hydus in the... Well, it's in the Adamir, but it will be XP lane. Okay, so I thought it would be gold lane because Adamir was holding it, but it will be in the XP lane. Now, Gear is going to be picking up that Benedetta. Okay, so I thought it would be something crazy like Adamir picking up the Hydus in the gold lane. But at least it's all equalized. Okay, so everything is normal now.
Yeah, it's kind of interesting because now Adamir is sacrificing that gold. Sacrificing a little bit to make it work. But JPL taking so much damage. Oh, that's some scary stuff.
That is scary, man. But oh yeah, it's going to be Wise, the one who is you. My God, the flame shot almost taking JPL down. But yes, this is Wise on the Kimmy. We've seen this before. It was the exact same response that they used to counter Dreon's Sicilian.
Yep. Yeah. Although I do find it interesting that it's going to be a Benedetta versus Clint situation. I wonder how confident Gear is. He also takes Execute as well.
I guess he's very confident. He's actually going to go for the 1v1. He's going to be able to almost win in a 2v1. Wise now coming in. This might be the kill picked up, but no, Gear is so good on these clutch moments on the Benedetta. This is what you want to play for. I like that EVO's SG are going for the risky Benedetta because this is going to be the X factor for them.
No. Go big or go home. That's what EVO says he wants to show us today. And with this Benedetta pick, although we don't know if it will work against Blacklist International, we like it all the same. Because again, it's playing to win and not playing not to lose.
Oh, that's so obnoxious there. Why is able to cancel the recalls there? He's going to lose a bit of EXP.
Yeah, for sure. JPL needs to keep that lane warm. For now, it's going to be very passive for EVO's SG because they do have the Sicilian.
Oh, no, that was very overzealous for the side of Potato. He tried to go for it, not knowing that Blacklist International have the chance to just rotate so fast. And that's the thing, all right? The execution is going to be the problem here. If they can execute the draft or not, because that goes the same. Every time you draft against Blacklist, you are forced to use some uncomfortable heroes. These heroes that you haven't touched for a very long time. This is what Blacklist did to Onyx. This is what they did to RRQ. And now it seems like that's what they're doing to EVO's SG.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of which, I don't know how comfortable they are letting Gear have this Benedetta. He had an outstanding performance the other time he was on that Benedetta. But the question is, can Gear actually hard carry this early to mid stage of the game and pull that pressure away like how Uranus usually does, but this time on a fighter slash assassin style?
At least for EVO's SG, even when they gave out this first turtle, there's not a massive lead that Blacklist International was able to get, though. So they're still quite on track now. As all my Venus now will be holding hands with Oheb into the top lane, making sure that he's not getting so much damage, as Gear will be able to just get on. Will not actually get the gold lane.
Oh, maybe he will eventually. Yeah, but in the mid lane, Selah will be able to outpoke Kimmy as usual. Is it going to be Wise just farming it up? Doesn't really want to go for any crazy fights on the board. Both teams still right now scaling, but Blacklist do have the lead.
It's quite a slow roll for now. Quite the slow roll. And especially since Turtle keeps farming on towards the bottom side of the map, most importantly, they need to make sure that the Hylos is able to participate in the fights because his ultimate is... Wait, Selah.
Oh my God, Selah is caught and that's going to be the flame shot. Not necessary, as that is a solo kill for Haji. The killing machine, the MVP machine, I think is a little bit of both. Maybe just a whole lot of both.
Oh yeah, we could see that with just the jump coming out from Haji, it's not enough against Sicilian. And we know that Sicilian is a farm-dependent hero. Gonna be saving back in the mid lane. Top though, go for Oheb.
Ooh, Oheb actually taking Gear very, very low right there. And this is the thing, right? What Gear really wants to do in this lane is not go for these trades because Venus is just going to be constantly babysitting Oheb. What he wants to do is create pressure via the side lane. Okay. Gear actually dashing in. Oheb still having the Flicker will choose to use it to get away. But Potato with a very good rotation to the top side. Meanwhile, Sicilian are still stacking in that mid.
Most importantly, the sacrificing turtle maybe make something happen up here with JPL. Holy baptism, going to stun him up just in time. They don't even get to get the free gold off of the energy plating.
Oh, wow. Okay, so unfortunately, not a good trade for EVO's SG as they wanted to go for a kill and then eventually that gold lane turret up top, or at least the outer turret and shields, but they will lose on the turtle as well as their orange buff.
Oh, wise though. It is going to be him stunned up by Atomir. It's going to be, oh, actually, okay. So much damage placed onto him. It's going to be the kill picked up by Atomir right now, but it's going to be the trade. Haji picking up another. Killing spree picked up. Potato looking for Edward. Doesn't have the Deathless Welcome. Doesn't have the Flicker. Will use it now, actually, and Gear is caught there in that top side, forced to back away as well. But Haji, he's the one that's gonna be able to chunk this turret, maybe even take it here. Nope, not enough damage, not enough minions. Nope, he doesn't care.
He still gets it at the end of the day. Right now, if EVO's SG want to maintain any kind of gold differential and not let it get to that 5k, Sayla really cannot afford to get solo killed in the mid lane.
I do love the play coming up from Atomir. He flickered forward and then used his glorious pathway to aid his teammates. As Wise was taken out by this jumping Hylos, but they do really need to make more of those plays. Unfortunately for EVO's SG, they have lost their mid lane turret. That's not really what they want in the early stages. And Blacklist International, in a snap, gets 2.7k gold ahead of EVO's SG.
Yeah, I don't know about this, because so far, you can kind of say that EVO's SG are playing to their composition strength, which is just waiting for those power spikes to happen to, you know, get to that point where those items are going to be built already, those three core items. But at the same time, do you want to be 3,000 gold behind of Blacklist International?
Well, definitely not, as Blacklist International is known as a team that can really abuse that. However, they still got the Nathan. This is the late game hero. Maybe for a wraparound, maybe they can really stretch this.
Yeah, let's see. Haji's going to be the target right now. JPL moving forward, as that's going to be the stun coming in onto Wise. Not enough damage right now. The cage not even connecting, as Wise is actually alone running towards the turtle. He pops the ultimate, unable to land it onto anyone, but those are a lot of resources already burnt away for EVO's SG. Meanwhile, Blacklist, they only used Wise's ultimate.
Yeah, there's really not much they can do about this so far. They just have to sacrifice these small leads over to Blacklist International until they get their own items. Like, take for an example, Sayla. He's looking to scale for as long as possible. Potato just wants to have a slow roll of his farm, not lose, try not to lose as much of it as possible, despite the fact that Wise is a level up on it. But if you look at the gold so far, pretty even.
Pretty even? Yeah, well, at least for the matchups. But overall, Blacklist International with 3,800 gold ahead of EVO's SG. This is off of the fact that they have controlled the neutral objectives.
Oh, let's see if Edward can survive. This is long to buy enough time. It's going to be Edward jumping in with Deathless Welcome. Will be able to connect onto Potato. And there's going to be the collapse. Potato getting picked up. Blacklist International now with the collapse. This is the ultimate bonding time. 7 minutes on the board. Adamir's going to be the target. Still able to run away. Gear now not going to try to do anything, as that is going to be a 2-0 for Blacklist. Perfect execution there by Edward to stay in it, but also very aggressive, maybe too aggressive from Potato. He didn't save the entropy to get away. He actually saved it. He used it for damage.
He used it for damage. Unfortunately, Edward actually freshly picked up the raided armor before that play coming up from EVO's SG.
Oh no, he went in. That is too over aggressive. He did get the wave, so I guess it is kind of worth it, but man, do you really want to be 5,000 gold behind a Blacklist?
I think there's no choice. It's either he sacrifices his life or he sacrifices the tier 2. And at this point, he cannot afford to lose mid-tier 2. The whole jungle is open and there is no safeguard to it. If mid-tier 2 falls, that means both tier 2s on top and bottom also will have to go for free.
Yeah, oh no, that's gonna be the glorious pathway used up by Atomir. Flicker as well as Ohev is looking for something. The ultimate connecting. Flame shot not yet available right now, as the holy healing will be able to get Atomir. The sniper! What is that, Ohev? He keeps on doing this on every hero.
Oh my god, don't let the Filipino sniper hold these kind of heroes, the marksman. With guns and Blacklist International, they're gonna push in the mid lane for sure.
Oh my god, the cage. Actually, now it is gonna be the time for Sayla to start doing damage with the Lightning Truncheon bot already and that Clock of Destiny. Just getting those stacks is gonna be crucial. So, right now, sure, Blacklist are in the lead. They have the tempo, but one mistake, if they ignore Sayla, let him free hit, it might be the turnaround.
Yep. We're actually looking for that combo. We almost saw that with the jump from Atomir, with the glorious pathway, maybe the flicker into a stun, eventually followed up by the claws coming out from this Sicilian. That could be a good combo, especially against Wise, who doesn't have Purify.
Oh,
the damage coming out of Oheb right now. They're going to be taking another tier 2. And I don't think Evil's SG has an entirely, has the tools necessary to actually get in on Blacklist, especially once they have a 6.6 gold K gold lead. It's really difficult to look for a catch. And if they start playing the front to front, it's very easy for Blacklist International to just overpower them with the overwhelming heal that they have from Oh My Venus.
Oh my God. I think the main problem here is that Adamir is 3 levels below of Edward, yeah. So he can't really match that Barret in the bottom side, though. They're looking for an engage. Oheb is going to get caught, flickering away. And what a beautiful disengage. Four-man collapse, and he's still able to run away now. Let's see what happens. Blacklist still trying to go for more, but yeah, both of them just disengaging, but that's going to be working for Blacklist because they pick up the tier 2 turret in the bot side.
Yeah. During the draft, we talked about how difficult it will be to deal well to deal against this Barret, and look at that. He already has his Oracle on top of the Radiant Armor. Majority of the damage from Evil's SG are magic damage, and I'm pretty sure that they will not be using gear just yet. They need more damage onto the heroes of Blacklist International, and that will only come from magic. This Nathan, this Sicilian, they only deal magic damage, and Edward just optimized so well against this.
Oh, let's see Adamir going for the engage once again, but it is onto Venus, the guy who has the Athenas. That's not going to be a lot of damage placed. Again, that is only half HP. Haji going for the backside. JPL going to get picked up. Gear now joining in with the final blow. Unable to find his target. Potato still able to kite away with the entropy being used. It's going to be the cage once more connecting onto two, but at what cost did that? You know, that's just way too expensive for them. They try to go for the purple buff, but in the end, they lost their roamer, and now it is prime time for Blacklist to keep on sieging.
Mm-hmm. Yep, Blacklist's position is just way too good right now, and as long as they play this front-to-front, EVOS SG has no real way of coming back into this.
Let's see, it's going to be the wave player coming in. Gear jumps in from the back side, still able to get away with Eye for an Eye. Adamir is going to get caught. Monster kill picked up by Haji, and it's just so depressing, frustrating to see for the side of EVOS SG. 7,000 gold lead, 9-1.
Yep. Great decision coming up from Blacklist International. They know that the Electo final blow was wasted around the purple buff. That's why they poked through the turret in the mid lane, aiming for a push actually, but because of the defense of EVOS SG, they had to sacrifice Adamir, and they got it. Now they're working on the Lord area. They know that there's no glorious pathway, no initiation from EVOS SG, and Blacklist International will just freely take this Lord.
Now this gear is trying to do something on the map. He is going to get a lot of pressure done on that top side, maybe even taking this tier 2. Nope, okay, he's going to back away right now. It is, though, a setup. A setup for a fight to come. But the thing is, how do you fight this?
I'm not entirely sure, because Haji is one of the biggest problems for EVOS SG. If anything goes wrong, he pops down that yin-yang overturn, and somebody's going to get blown up, whether it be Sela, whether it be JPL, and most importantly, Gear, who can't get into the fight as long as Haji is sticking around. I think it's a good idea for EVOS SG to kind of slow down this game by cutting the waves, and most importantly, trying to get some extra pressure and forcing it to be a 4v4, yep. Something which at least EVOS SG can look to focus on just mainly high ground defense. But no, Gear goes down to Wise.
Solo kill! When solo do you kill. See that? Benedetta getting solo kill, but it's going to be Adamir jumping in, trying to zone away the members right now, but he's not tanky enough to do that. Blacklist just completely ignores him as Adamir goes into recall right now. It is going to be the Lord taken out by Wise. He is in the backside. Adamir is going to be caught in the bad situation with the Ice Queen 1, just getting the kill, getting the damage. It is a 2-0. Blacklist International looking for the end.
Yep, I mean, this is it. That's a 10k gold lead. 13 minutes. It took a little bit longer, but I think this might just be checkmate. Potato!
Oh, entropy still being used, but it's going to be the Filipino sniper getting the double kill. Now Gear going to the backside, still able to deal some damage, but he's going to get taken down by Wise. Now only Sela, Detonus welcome to bring him back to the team. He gets taken down, and Blacklist are at match point.
What a game coming out from Blacklist International once again. Edward, the Barret for back-to-back games. He is a problem for EVOS SG. Just keeping on top of the heroes of EVOS SG, forcing them to use some of their skills. And then it's up to the Filipino sniper as well as Wise to just deal the damage.
I mean, they're just so consistent. But Haji looking like an absolute killer here with that yin-yang overturn, continuing to get ahead, continuing to lock EVOS SG out of their games.
Honestly, like, this
it's just
is
so good.
Domination.
Domination indeed. They started with the laning stage, and even with just the solo plays, we see Wise, a Kimmy, outplay a Benedetta.